This is going to be a review of Elementor Extras. It's an add-on package for Elementor. I've been using it on my website for the last 2 months. It's about time I review and show you some of the great things about it and some of the things that aren't quite as expected about this add-on package. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make a bunch of Elementor tutorial videos for non-techies. I make this stuff make sense. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button. And if you want notifications when I put a video up, there's a bell. You can click on that and YouTube will let you know. All right, Elementor Extras. Actually, you know what? Here's their website right here, Elementor Extras. Oops, I'm going to show you some things here. I'll have a link in the video description box. You can go to wpcrafter.com/eextras to go over there. That is not a referral link. So let me show you how I'm using it, and then I'm going to show you the actual plugin or where I'm using it on my website. I use it in very subtle ways. There's a couple things that it does that enhances Elementor, and I really like this plugin. One of the things I like the most about it is it's not trying to be an Elementor Pro clone like so many of these other add-on packages. So I only use two of the add-on packages on my website, Elementor Extras and Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor. Okay, so I use this really cool feature they have called Tooltip. So if you scroll down here and click on one of these links here, I have this page all set up. Now on this page, I want to remind people that if they're going to order Elementor to do it in a private or incognito window. And so when they go down here to these buttons, watch what happens when you hover. It gets this tooltip and it says, remember to open the link in a private window. So it has this really cool tooltip feature that I think is just perfect for me. These little enhancements to Elementor. So one of them is the tooltip. I love it. You have full styling control. Let me show you a more practical for everybody else example. So you know, okay, so if I go to my blog here, you can see I have my list of posts, right? And this is an Elementor Pro module that allows you to have this grid. But what Elementor Extras does is it gives you enhancements. So let me show you where I'm actually using that. So if I click on reviews right here and I scroll down, see this right here? It is a filter. It's called the Taxonomy Filter. So essentially these are the categories that I have each of these reviews in. So say I wanted to see reviews for WordPress membership plugins. Instead of scrolling down and trying to find it in the whole list, someone can click on that and it just shows it to, shows it to them right there. I'm short a couple featured image or hosting. So someone can click here and it just shows them the ones that are hosting. And you see how lightning fast that is. And this is one of those enhancements that you get with Elementor Extras. Okay, so those are two ways that I'm actually using it. Now let's take a look at it really quick. So it's going to provide a couple things for you. Number one, it's going to provide additional modules that you can use. And you know, when you look at them, you can really tell the care that went into making these modules. So there's a few modules that it adds. I'm going to show you in a moment. And then it also has those enhancements that I was talking about. So, okay. So when I scroll down here, so here's one of the things they say, it's by designers. And actually they're not just saying it. They actually have a fantastic design eye when they're making these, and uniquely useful. I think, wow, this is some very accurate copy for a change. All right. So, so here's some of the highlights of it. Let me scroll down here and just show you a list of the elements that it comes with. Okay, buttons. Whenever possible, I'm going to use the default Elementor version of various add-ons. So if there's an add-on package that has one, I'd prefer to use the one that comes with Elementor. All right, so it's also important to highlight the fact that you don't need Elementor Pro to use this, but some of the enhancements, like that filter that I showed you a moment ago, it's a Elementor Pro enhancement, okay? So you get this really cool timeline widget, switcher. I'll have to show you this in a moment. This is really cool. I'm going to show you this in a moment too. The HTML5 video. This is actually really cool. Circle progress. I don't get excited about that kind of stuff. Hotspots. That's fine. Devices is pretty neat. gallery, image comparison. Okay, what else do I like here? Post extra, that's that filter I'm going to show you in a moment. Table, that's one of the gotchas. It's not their fault, though. And inline SVG, I'm supposing you could use that to have an SVG logo if you're using Elementor Pro. All right, and it adds sticky elements. And so I think this might overlap with a feature in Elementor Pro that was recently released. A lot of people like this because you get all kinds of parallax options. So for you parallax lovers, this is the only show in town to really get control, parallax control. So you can have it on elements or background. That is really neat. And there's my silly little thing I like, this global tool tip. This is actually a paid add-on. I should have clarified that in the beginning. They have three different options, single site, unlimited, and a lifetime. And you could see it here in euros. So whatever that is in your currency, just go ahead and do the numbers. I know in dollars, it's a larger number. Okay, so this is that. Let me just go through some of the things that I think are really neat about here. Okay, so here is the inline SVG. I'm assuming if you wanted to do an SVG of your logo, it's kind of technical stuff there. It's actually the best way to have a logo. You could probably use this module for that. Here's the table module. This is the only one where it's not their fault. I'm going to show you. It's not so easy to use, but it's not their fault. It's just the way that Elementor is. But you can make some beautiful tables here. I mean, these are really nice tables. Tables are really helpful. Google loves tables on your posts and pages for sure. Right here is for additional settings for your post grid. So what I showed you on my blog, your post grid, there's additional options that it gives you. And here it tells you, so here's the feature that I'm using. It's called the Taxonomy Filters. I don't know why this isn't in the module by default, custom post type support. But anyways, here's the features that come with that. I really like the options, but for me, it really boils down to this taxonomy filter. I love that. Okay, this is actually really neat. It's called Switcher. It's this feature of switching between photographs, and this is where you can see that this is built by designers, and you can really do some, it's almost perfectly matching Elementor, because Elementor itself was made for designers. So here's all these different ways of progressing through images. So if you just sit here for a second, you'll see some really cool transitions. I think this one I have to click on like that. So there's just some really neat things that you can do with that. Here's that HTML5 video player. So you have full control over the styling of this video player, which I think is very nice to have if you're going to have a video here or there on your website. So you see three examples here of some of the controls that you have over with the style and the colors and all of that, so you can match your branding. Buttons faster. Actually, I haven't even really explored their button options. It looks like the main thing with it is having the side-by-side button. I don't get too excited about that stuff. Here it is, the parallax elements. So you can see as I'm scrolling, the text here is scrolling at a different pace from the image. That's parallax. And here's some more parallax. And you see how it's doing different things, moving in different directions. So you can do some really neat things like that. Here's your background parallax. So you can just see right there, you can go left, right, and there's angles, there's different things you can do. And my favorite, the tooltip. This is cool. So you can have an entire module have a tooltip get triggered like that. Okay, so here I am. I'm just going to show you this really quick. So I already have it installed and activated on this website. So here's my pro elements, but when I scroll down, my theme elements, my general elements, my WordPress elements, and here it is, Elementor Extras. So let me show you this right here. So here's the table module, and this is the one that I think I was disappointed with the most, and it wasn't their fault. It's the way that Elementor works. So when I drag and drop it, it automatically creates this 3x3 grid. Now when I click on it, you see this is a little complicated how it works. So first you set up your rows, And then let me expand right here where it says content. And then you have this weird way of setting it all up. So it's a little complicated to set up at first. So you have your header row. I'm probably not explaining it the best. And then we have the content row here. It's weird. So if I want to add a fourth row here, it's really complicated to set up. So if I just click on that, you could see I clicked on add an item, but I don't have a new row. Now I have it here, and then I need to click into it, and then I need to specify that it's just complicated, okay? You'll understand. Now, when it's set up, it's a beautiful thing, but it's just a little on the complicated side to set up. Any module has that tooltip. Let's see where that is. I think that's going to be found right here in the advanced. So, you know, the enhancements that it adds to the various modules under advanced, you're going to have this extras right here. And this is where you can enable or disable the sticky, the parallax, or the tooltip. So when you do that, it's going to reveal additional options. I really like this tooltip a lot. It's got to be one of my favorite features. And you get all the control that you could want over the settings for this little extra bit that it adds. It's pretty fantastic if you ask me. So now let me show you that taxonomy filter. So what you need to do for that is scroll down to the bottom and you'll choose post extras like this, drag and drop it. And then right here you would set up how you want your post grid to look. But when you scroll down a little bit, there's this option here that says enable filters, and then you can enable this, and then it reveals this option right here that says filters. So see, when it's gone, my filters option isn't there, but when you toggle it, the filters option is there. So I would go like that, and I would choose what I want it to be off of. Is it going to be categories or tags? So in my example, on my website, I chose categories, and that's how it showed the categories right there at the top. And so there's some various options that you have here to control this and also the style of it. I really find that a useful feature that I end up using a lot. So let me go ahead and get rid of that and that. So anyways, oops, this is Elementor Extras. I think it's a really good plugin. I mean, it's very well built. And I think that if you need just a couple of the things that it does, it's worth adding to your website arsenal to be able to have the flexibility of doing these things from within Elementor. And one of the things I like the most about it is that it stays, for the most part, out of Elementor's lane. So Elementor Pro has its paid product, right? Elementor makes Elementor Pro. I don't like these add-on packages that just try to be clones of Elementor Pro to kind of steal sales away from Elementor Pro. Because if people don't buy Elementor Pro, there's not going to be an Elementor. And so anyways, I have links down below to this. If you don't have Elementor Pro and you're interested in that, visit WPCrafter.com/Elementor. It actually takes you to that page that I was on down here where I tell you if you do purchase Elementor through the link on this page, according to the instructions, I give you this course I made called Elementor Essentials. There's about, I think, over 50 lessons in there. It's a course on how to use Elementor to create beautiful websites, complete websites. It's about more than just Elementor, though. It's normally $199. I give it to you for free as a bonus to help you learn Elementor if you purchase it through this link, whatever. Okay, anyway, so I'll also have a link to Elementor and Extras down below as well. Let me know what you think about Elementor Extras if you are using it. I know this is probably the original Elementor add-on package. I think it came out, geez, it might almost be a year ago. This is like probably the original one. So if you're using it, let me know how you are using it and some creative uses for that down below. Hey, if you found any value in this video, if you could give it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, comment section down below. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.